It's another exclusive, only from DJ Michael B.
At this time, we'd like to welcome to the Other Side of Hollywood radio show, Vicky Stone, who's been living a victorious life. I can see it in my own eyes. And Vicky, we'd like you to tell our audience what happened to you.
Well, last year, November 5th, I was well around that time, you can say. My knee was really beginning to bug me, and I really noticed it when I was in a dance class, and I started getting really lazy, and I wasn't doing things, and so I was sent to the health office, and there the nurse, you know, checked my knee out, and it was swollen, so she said, go to the doctor. Well, I go, okay, I didn't really want to, because I thought it wasn't serious at all. But he ended up taking x-rays, and there was a tumor on my knee, and I didn't know anything for quite a while. But within the next day, they pulled me out of school, and I went to the hospital, and they had a biopsy, and it ended up being cancer. And they told me that within 2 weeks, if I would have been walking around, my leg would have collapsed, and, you know, that would have been it for me. But luckily, they found it in time, but the only procedure for it was to remove my leg, which was a bummer, but it saved my life. And that's really, you know, was really hard on me, but, you know, it's something that I had to go through. There was no choice. And, you know, it's really, the Lord's really helped me out through this stuff because, I mean, I've never been happier in my whole life. And things, I mean, I've had a lot of bummers. Like, I'm on chemotherapy now. And then a couple months after that, I had lost my hair. And I was always into, like in school, I always had to have my hair just perfect. And I had to walk right. And everything had to be really cool. And, you know, I had lost almost everything that I ever thought I had before, which really didn't mean anything before. But it's just like, oh, there's so much I had learned. But through it all, like, the Lord really just, I don't know, he just really showed me that, you know, life is so much more important than all the little surfacey things we see. And, you know, how to really just to move on in him. You don't have to let these things get you down. And it's just, I don't know, I've never experienced things like this, of course, but it's just really something beautiful that's happened. And then I did find another spot on my back, and it was on my vertebrae. So I was laid up in the hospital for a couple weeks with that, to remove the tumor and put part of my rib there. But so another big burden on me was I was in a big body cast from my neck down to my hips, and really emotionally that was really hard. I'd see people and I'd want to start crying, you know, and that was really a bummer. But now I'm in a smaller cast. It's just so neat because my hair is growing back, and the Lord just brings me little things. I'll start getting really out of it, and things just get better. I just think.
Thank you.
to me. And our Lord Jesus Christ can't give up. Gotta keep on keeping on. We're talking with Vicky Stone, who had a leg amputated because of cancer. And we're sharing with you about the victory in Jesus Christ. Now after this happened, how did your friends react to you after this?
Well, I found who my real friends were. At school, I never had real relationships, but now I'm not in school right now. I have a tutor because I go for treatments all the time, but yeah, you really find who your friends are when something happens.
Did you get to witness to the other kids while you were in the children's hospital?
Well, a lot of times the kids are really young. I go to children's hospital in Los Angeles. But, well, I get to talk to the nurses a lot. You know, the kids are there, so out of it, but yeah, you know, sometimes I get to pray with the little kids if they're real sick, you know, and it's pretty neat.
During the time that you were in children's hospital, was there anyone else that had the same problem as you did?
Oh, yes. There are about 10 kids I can think of right now that have had the same thing happen to them. You know, it's osteogenic sarcoma, and it's all the same ways, and like all the girls, we all went through it in a way together. We all lost our hair at the same time, and even the funny thing was most of us all had brown hair too, you know, it was just long brown hair and our right leg and just everything, but it's just, you know, you just really, you learn a lot through trials, but, you know, you either, you know, can really let it get you bummed out and down, and you can withdraw or just really come out of it beautifully with the Lord, and, you know, like I said, I'm really happy, and it's not something phony, but it's really something to do.
Thank you.
Victor and Victory, is Vicky Stone on the other side of Hollywood? Now, we all know how our parents love us, our brothers and sisters, how they love us too. How does this affect your family?
Oh, it was hard on them. But a lot of times, like, when, you know, we hear bad news and stuff, it was like, Lord, I almost had, like, my parents, you know, you have to cheer them up, but it's just like, they're really, the Lord, my brothers, and, you know, I know they really, because we all are really close, and it was really hard on them, but, you know, they're seeing it's going to be okay, and, you know, I mean, what can you do? You know, you can't, you know, slip out, I mean, you can, but it's not going to help.
Could you say that the Lord is helping you through all of this?
Well, you can't do it without him. You can try, but mentally and emotionally, you can't. Physically, sometimes. But I just have to depend on him. It's no other way.
We really appreciate the fact that you came and you shared your life with our listening audience, Vicky.
I'm really glad that I had a chance to talk to you and to really get to share this. Not that, you know, I'm a big thing that I've gone through. It's not even that. It's just like the Lord can. Like, when you have trials and you have all those problems, like for me, one thing I always do is think, when I get bummed out, I always go, God, somebody else might have it worse than me. Like, I even have friends who are worse off, but, you know, it's just like, God, man, right now, I'm feeling fine. Things are going so good, I should be praising the Lord, thanking him, you know?
You wrote a couple of songs. Would you share just a little bit about them?
Well, the first one I wrote about a month ago, I have a friend, Kathy Eldridge, and Christine Eldridge, and she's been really sick, and I've never really met her, but I've talked to her on the phone quite a few times, and like we always say, we believe, you know, we really believe the Lord is going to bring us through this and heal us, and so one day I was just sitting by my piano, just thinking about the Lord, and it's just like he gave me a vision of a field of flowers, and like we always say, when we're here, we're going to run through it together, you know, or just even, you know, emotionally run through it, just, you know, in every way, just run, you know, and praise the Lord. And so the words are, I'll just give you some of them, but it's like, out in the distance, a field of flowers, of all different shades and sizes, we're watching and waiting for our day to come, when we will be made whole. And there's more verses, but it's just like, that's the main idea. So even, it's even more of a, you know, spiritual healing it can be too. And then I wrote another one about, like, you know, don't look into the future, don't look back at your past, but live each moment now. And, you know, it's just really been a blessing to me.
Thank you.
of Hollywood radio shows sharing victory in Jesus Christ. And to have that victory, you're going to have to love him more each and every day. The Imperial.
Darkness was the rule of my time. Came along and brought the light. Lonely was the story I told. Came along and took control.
With us. And before we go, we're going to ask her just one more question. What have you learned in the past year? What is the most significant thing that you've learned to help you in your Christian walk?
Well, that's a hard question. I've learned a lot. Personally, I've learned to look to the Lord. Like, before, I was so hung up in myself and how I always had to look right, be right, do this, do that, and it's just like the Lord's showing me, you don't need that, you know, you can do it with him, you don't need to be cool. What is cool? What is, you know, all this stuff? What is beautiful? You know, what is so-and-so? And it's just, I don't know, that's really been something I've really been learning. It's hard because I'll see other people and I'll, a lot of the time I go, God, I wish I looked like them, but then I don't. We are all beautiful and God made us beautiful. You know, we're all individual and it's just, you know, we should really be thankful for who we are, what we are. We might not be the most beautiful person in the world, but inside you can be.
Lily Green.
You run so fast, working for the Lord, and you think he's good, but I think he's probably bored. And you call yourself a Christian, but you hardly even know your Lord. Why don't you sit down for a while, take some time, and appreciate the Lord? Well, there's lots of time to sing about. There's lots of time to run about. But you gotta take time to get alone and just sit down and
Radio Show. I'd like to thank Vicky Stone for spending her time with us to share about her victorious life in Jesus Christ, but her trials are turned to gold. And if you would like to write to Vicky Stone and share your life with her, you may do so by writing her at Post Office Box 3802, Hollywood, California 90028. She just celebrated her 16th birthday about a week ago. God bless you. Thank you.